Alhamdulillah. Allahumma laka alhamdu hamdan tayyiban mubarakan yurfika anna ya rabbil alameen. Allahumma laka alhamdu hamdan tayyiban yamla'u as-samawati wa yamla'u al-arda wa ma baynahuma wa ma shi'ta ya maulana ma shi'ta ba'd. Alhamdulillah wa ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan rasulullah. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. أحبابي في الله, the issue of today, the topic of today is so significant. We need to speak about something very, very important. First, we need to ask, how many times do we have to live before the day of Al-Qiyamah? It is a very big question and nobody is talking. And what is the story of the human being? What is the story of yourself? From where you came? And where are you going? And how long you are going to stay here? Significant questions and nobody at all touches this area. And nobody aware the area that is lived by our interpreters, they are living it and the others are living it as well. And nobody spoke about this one. I'm not going to speak about it. But I wish to speak about today. Ahbab fillah, bi qawlihi subhanahu wa ta'ala, kayfa takfuruna billahi wa kuntum amwata. How you are going to ignore me and you are here. You were here, and then you passed away. وَكُنْتُمْ أَمْوَاتًا. How you are going to ignore me, and you were here. It is talk very simple and very clear. It doesn't want any interpretations, أَحْبَبِ فِي. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is asking, how you are going to ignore me, and you were here with me. كَيْفَ تَكْفُرُونَ بِاللَّهِ وَكُنْتُمْ أَمْوَاتًا فَأَحْيَاكُمْ. So, we didn't come from nothing. No, we were there, but we were dead. And then now we brought alive. And then we are going to die again. And then we are going to be alive again. كَيْفَ تَكْفُرُونَ بِاللَّهِ وَكُنْتُمْ أَمْوَاتًا فَأَحْيَاكُمْ. You were dead, and we brought you alive. And you are going to die. وَكُنْتُمْ أَمْوَاتًا فَأَحْيَاكُمْ ثُمَّ يُمِيتُكُمْ ثُمَّ يُحْيِيكُمْ. You are going to die again and he is going to bring you alive again. So if somebody was dead, if you saw anybody who is dead, what does it mean? He was alive. So it means that we are alive in Jannah with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if somebody is speaking and listening and talking and making conversations and going and coming and invited for a meeting with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and then going away and going to court to listen to a court order and then coming back, is he working like a machine without any oil, without any butter? He was eating and drinking and sleeping. So we were living in Jannah and we were eating and sleeping and enjoying Jannah. But the problem was is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala want to divide Jannah, distribute Jannah on his people. How are you going to distribute it? This man deserves a good district, and this one deserves a country, but this one deserves nothing. How come this one? No, he deserves everything. So he sent us to dunya in order to earn your place in al-akhirah yourself. That's all. You have come to dunya in order to choose your place yourself. Some people are going to choose, and some people are going to take lots and lots of territories, and some people are going to have nowhere at all. At all. Where are they going to go? They are going to go to the hellfire. They are going to stay there because they forgot something that they were called to hear. A call to hear in Al-Ula, the year before. This is my term. In my research, here before, dunya hereafter. The here before they were a court order. And it was not deeply enough, Ahmadullah, في قوله سبحانه وتعالى, and the only words that come saying a court order. وقضى وقضى. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is always saying, Allah is giving you orders to perform salah, giving you orders to give zakah, to give charity, is giving you orders to visit your relatives, giving you orders. But here in this one he said, giving a judgment. وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّاهُ. This one a court order. You will have to worship nobody but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Pass. Can you imagine a human being left Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and brought an idol or a status and worshiping a status? I have never believed it. And I thought when I was little in school that the teacher was joking. And when I went to older, I found it really, it is a truth. How do you imagine that some people are worshipping things but from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? We were in Jannah with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the people are saying that Jesus alayhi salam is the son of Allah. Hasha Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I want to tell you a very little story, and I have told it to some in the university and in a church. I see this one. When I was a child, Ahbabullah, they asked me, I was in a Christian school, nursery. And then we were told to do a story. A story, everybody will do a story or say a tale or something. So I said one day the elephant was walking in the desert, in the forest, and found an ant he loved there and married to him, and got a little elephant as little as this. As little as this from the ant. And it was a nice family, the elephant was walking and he has on his back the ant, his wife, and her son, the little elephant. So all of them in the school laughed and said, the teacher told me, how's the elephant? Will marry the ant. So I told him, how Jesus is the son of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is our prophet. The children, all of them, or say 90% of them, they were Christian. And about 10% were Muslims. I think it was in 2006. I found nobody to meet me because it was a Friday and the university was closed. So I found somebody standing, saying, are you? And he called me in my name. I said, who are you? Where have I seen him? And then he said, this is my name. I was with you in the nursery before. And then I'm going to take you with me home. So I went to him because I have to go to home. And then when I went to him, I entered a very big building. A very big building, as big as a church, as a region to Baghdad Mosque. I asked him, what are you doing here? He said, I am the priest of this church. And then he took me inside in order to pray all together, to pray Asr. I put a man and a little mosque inside the church. I prayed with him. I told him, لَا يُؤَمُّ الرَّجُلُ فِي بَيْتِهِ. A rajul, the man, is not going to lead or be led in salah, for salah in his house. So if I am in your house, you are the imam. He said, La wallahi, it's you that will be our imam. So I prayed imam, and then in Maghrib he prayed imam, and he started in his Quran. And he made me cry, and he cried, man. And he spoke, and I forgot completely that he was the priest, in order to discuss with him. So I asked him, my brother, you said you are the priest of this church. Do you have any people to pray here? He said, no one at all. At all. When I went to the TV the following day, I asked this question, why is this church in this place? So the British ambassador said, if we have a Muslim, a mosque in a place where no Muslim at all there and nobody's praying, nothing wrong. Because all of them blamed me and they wanna charge me for this talk, why do you say there's a church in this place? And anyway, this is not about what I'm speaking about. So I asked him, "Who will you when converted to Islam?" He said, "Since the elephant married the ant." See, the children, baby fellah, do understand. He said, "Since the elephant married the ant." He does remember 40 years back when he was in nursery. And he spoke and he remembers me since that time. I asked him to declare that he is a Muslim. He said, "I'm going to lose my contract because he is contracted as a priest. And if he left, he's going to go. See the fitna. See the fitna. Ahbabi fillah wa ara al fitna. Nowadays, ahbabi fillah wa ara another fitna here and everywhere in a way. Britain is the best country. It's the best country for that because some people are saying because we are in Britain and the kids are having their freedom. No, Allah. Ahbabi fillah, a child came to me from the same country, the same, from the Gulf, to the university to study law. And his name is Muhammad. And he's asking me, when he asked about me, they told him he's in the mosque downstairs. He's asking me, what do you do when you go to mosques? I told him, what do we do when we go to mosques? He said, yes. I told him, my child, you know, I was born there and I never been to England. I've just come. I've just arrived. He has just arrived from Qatar. And you can't speak Arabic or one word? He said, no, because I was in an English school. And you can't, you don't know what we do in mosques? I said, no. I told him, we drink tea and coffee. So when we go to a mosque, we drink tea and coffee. And he said, that is why my dad goes every Friday. His dad goes every Friday and the liver told him, come with me once to pray, Ahbabi fillah. And his son named Muhammad in an Arabian country and he doesn't know how to pray, he doesn't know how to recite Al-Fatiha. Al-Fatiha, Ahbabi fillah. A lady called Shafiqa, Ummi Shafiqa, our sister in Islam, after growing her children in London and they have become solicitors and university degrees and everything, they can pray, they can speak Arabic, they can recite the Quran, they left the house for freedom. It is nobody's mistake, Ahbabi fillah. And it is not because we are in London. It is because of al-waswas al-khannas alladhi yuwaswisu fi sudur al-nas min al-jinnati wal-nas. Al-waswas al-khannas shadid, strong, Ahbabi fillah. When somebody keep blah, 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 inside somebody's ears and whispering, and your freedom and you are and you can go and you can go to the bubble together and you can do this and you will be free and this. Al-waswas al-khannas. Who way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked us to seek refuge of al-waswas al-khannas? Because al-waswas al-khannas can take you from the freedom of Islam to the prison of the shaitan. And he makes you think that this is the prison of Islam and this is the freedom of the shaitan. And it is the other way around. When somebody goes with the shaitan, he actually has become in his hand imprisoned. Prisoned by the shaitan, he can't do nothing but what the shaitan is telling him to do. And he thinks he's right. Let Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to return her children back to her. Allahumma yaka nas'al ya maulana al-azim an tahdi lana iyalana wa an tashfiha wa an tarud ilayha iyalaha. Another friend, Ahbabi fillah, from a small, my friend, my close friend, telling me a child kept on his phone playing games until he is ill with tawahid. He is locking himself up in his room, he doesn't want to see anybody. A good child in the university, studying law in the university. And the two girls are going, when they leave home, they take the hijab out, they change the uniform outside the house. It is because of the waswas al-khannas alladhi yuwaswisu fi sudur al-nas min al-jinnati wal-nas. Keep repeating it in home, and keep repeating it when you go out, and keep repeating it when you are in. أحبابي في الله أن سيد بسم الله الذي لا يضر مع اسمه شيء في الأرض ولا في السماء وهو السميع العليم. أولي when you say your children will be fine, your kids will be fine, yourself and your wife at home, in case your wife get out as well for freedom. It has become a problem. نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يهدي لنا أزواجنا وأن يغفر لنا ذنوبنا وأن يهدي لنا عيالنا وأن يلبسهم نباتا حسنا. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. اللهم لك الحمد حمدا طيبا مباركا نرضيك عنا يا رب العالمين. اللهم إياك نسأل في يومنا هذا أن تعطي كل من حضر هذه الصلاة مسألته. اللهم إياك نسأل يا مولانا العظيم أن تقضي لكل من حضر هذه الصلاة حاجته. اللهم إياك نسأل يا مولانا العظيم أن تعز الإسلام والمسلمين وأن تجعلهم الوارثين وأن تغنيهم في الدنيا والآخرة. أحبابي في الله, there are so many stories, but upsetting the mother and the father is something illegal in the court of heaven. And returning back to the story, I was, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala always in the Quran saying, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَأْمُرُكُمْ أَنْ تُقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةَ تُؤْتُوا الزَّكَاةَ. Everything يَأْمُرُكُمْ وَأَقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَآتُوا الزَّكَاةَ. But worshiping is the way to worship for al-ibadah. He said, waqaba. Waqaba means a judgment was in a court, was in al-ula, before we come to dunya. Waqaba rabbuka alla ta'budu illa iyyah. This is only two things. The first one, to worship nobody but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And to know that that he is al-ahad al-fadl al-samad al-lazi lam yalid wa lam yulad wa lam yakul lahu kufuwa al-ahad. You will have Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala introduced himself to us. And he said that I am so and so and so. He said, هو الله الذي لا إله إلا هو عالم الغيب والشهادة. He knows what happened. He knows what is going to happen. He knows what is going on now. عالم الغيب والشهادة. هو الرحمن الرحيم سبحانه وتعالى. He said, وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّاهُ. So this is number one you will have to achieve, you are in Jannah. Is there anything else? Yes. وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. الْوَالِدَيْنِ, it is just with worshiping, straight away. Supposing my parents are shaitans. وَصَاحِبْهُمَا فِي الدُّنْيَا مَعْرُوفًا. You will have to be the best friend to them in either, in whatsoever case. You will have to love your parents always, all the time, whether they are good or bad. So there is no any excuse for anybody to leave his parents at all. At all saying, no, 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 I need my freedom. What freedom you are seeking, Ahbabi Habibi Fillah? You will have to stay with your parents. And after this, إِمَّا يَبْلُغَنَّ عِنْدَكَ الْكِبَرَ أَحَدُهُمَا أَوْ كِلَاهُمَا. If one is left of them, he is weaker. You will have to look after this one that is left, whoever. He is a father or a mother. A father or a mother. أو كلاهما, or both of them. If they are both of them, you will have to look after them. You will have to be with them all the time. Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, رَغُمَ أَنْف. He never said رَغُمَ أَنْف. It means his dignity. Himself, his body, everything is azab. رغم أنف من أدرك والديه أو أحدهما ولم يدخلها الجنة. رغم أنف means he will be with the مجرمين, he will be with the كفار, one who caught his mother before she died, or his father, or both of them, and they were not a reason to take him to Jannah. They will not have a reason to take him to Jannah. Ahbabi fi Allah, your father, if he is still there now, or your mother, it is your chance. Your chance, Habibi fi Allah, don't let them go without you are in Jannah. Well, they are in dunya, Habibi. All our young people, I am speaking to you. Somebody, Habibi fi Allah, a Sahabi was dying. I'm not gonna keep it for long. Only this one in a minute. This Sahabi was dying and he can't say Shahada. He's a young man, came from war, he was hit with a sword, and they know that he was dying. So the Sahaba asked him to say La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. He can't say it. He speak about what is going to happen and about his wills and about him. And but say La ilaha illallah. They say, call me Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The same thing that is asking for sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to come here to help him to get Shahada out. The one sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came and said, does he have a mother? They said, yes. Are you satisfied with your son? She said, yes, my son, Habib is going. And he said, lady, you love your son and you are forgiving him for all. She said, no, but there is one which I can't forgive him. One little thing. It's a very little thing, Ahmad. She said, he will use it to bring fruits and things from the market and they come home. He used to give it to his wife first and making his wife the boss on me. And I'm just like a little kid in the house. So his wife, the boss, is giving me my share like the other children in the house. And I hated this one and I'm not going to forgive him. Because I am his mother and I should be the boss of the house. The boss of the house and his wife should have been calling me mom. But she is dealing with me like a child. Can you imagine this one to stop the man uttering Shahada? This one stopped him to say La ilaha illallah when he is possible. If he didn't say it, you know where he is going. Stay forever in the hellfire because he was giving the fruit to his wife, not to his mother. And then he upsets her. His wife apologized to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We saw that this will disturb her, so I am washing the fruit and I am cleaning it and this, I am giving her share clean. Clean. She said, I would have liked to wash it myself. She is upset. So you will have to ask your mother first to work, would she like my mom to help you or she will help you or I will help you. Straight away, Ahmed Filan, make sure your mother is not upset and your father. And your father, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us an example. Ya bunay, inni ara fi al-manam anni asbahu. But he said, go away. My father, no. He said, ya abati fa'al matu'ma. Satajiduni, inshaAllah, min al-sabreen. And he is going to slaughter him with a knife, ahbabi fillah. He was worried about his father. He's not worried about himself. Natural love from the heart. You will have to love your parents out of your heart and stay with them, and this is your freedom. The freedom of Islam. Ahbabi fillah. Nas'al Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala an yahdina ilayh. Allahumma ahdi lihdina ilayka wahdi atfalana. Allahumma ahdi iyalana. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا اللهم اهد لنا ازواجنا ربنا واغفر لنا خطايانا وارزقنا جنات النعيم ربنا لا تضع لنا في يومنا هذا ذنبا الا غفرته ولا هما الا فرجته ولا دينا الا قضيته ولا ميتا الا رحمته ولا حاجه من حوائج الدنيا ولا الاخره الا قضيتها لنا برحمتك يا ارحم الراحمين وصل اللهم وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى اله وصحبه وسلم والحمد لله رب العالمين.